Hi guys, tonight I'm going to show you a really cute project that I made using the Simon Says Stamps Lunchbox Notes dies that I just picked up. These things are super adorable. I'm planning on making 3 Halloween shaker cards with them. Here are some supplies that I'm using: this and that, score tape, and some foam tape. And I also have my favorite things, black licorice hybrid ink for stamping. I have 4 stamp sets. The first one is Which Way is the Candy by My Favorite Things. I have this one just for backup. It's Happy Haunting by My Mind's Eye. The next set is really cute. It's Monster Mash by Lawn Fawn. And the last set that I have is also by Lawn Fawn, and it is Spooktacular. I'm going to use images and sentiments from that. I have some sequins set aside. And then I have my cardstock, which is black licorice. I have grape jelly, orange fizz, all from MFT, My Favorite Things. I have Nina White, solar white cardstock in 80-pound weight, and some acetate. So let's get into this. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take my little clippers and I'm going to clip apart my dies. And the reason why I'm doing this is you can leave them together, but since I'm making a shaker card, I need to create a window, so I do have to cut them apart. The first thing I'm going to do is cut my paper in 3-inch width, and then I'm going to cut it 3 inches the opposite way as well. So I'm going to make a 3-inch box. So that's the first thing I'm going to do. And then I'm going to do the same thing with the grape jelly paper. I'm going to do 3 inches and then cut it again at 3 inches. And that's going to be the frame of the shaker card. And then the next piece I'm going to cut is 3 inches by 6 inches. That's going to be the card base. I'm going to score it at 3 inches and fold it over, and it'll be the card. I'm going to repeat the same process with the orange fizz, cut it 3 inches, and then I'm going to cut it again at 3 inches, and then I'm going to do the card base, which is going to be 3 inches by 6 inches. So you're going to see me cut that one as well. So I went ahead and cut all my papers, and you can see I have the black, the grape, and the orange. And then I also did the bases that I'm going to stamp on. Now those papers were cut by 3x3, as well as the acetate, but the white and the acetate are a little too large. I end up cutting them down later, but you'll see that later on in the video. And here are my card bases. So the next thing I'm going to do is take out my score pal, and I'm going to score each one of the card bases at 3 inches. And I'm going to do that for each of the 3 cards. And I'm just going to fold them over and use my bone folder or my score tool to fold them over and crease them, so there's a really nice, clean, crisp fold on each of the cards. So all of my papers have been cut and everything is ready to go. So we're going to go on to the next step. Here I used the first die on each of the frame pieces that I cut that were 3x3. My die cutting machine is not where I can film right now. I will change that in the future, but I went ahead and did that. Now I used the second die to cut a little window in each one of those because I'm creating a shaker card, so I need to have the window. And there's that second die right there. It's the smaller square, and I really love the detail on this die. It came out really cute. I love how each of the frames came out. Okay, my next step is to take this or that score tape and line it all on the inside of this shaker card frame. Now, my problem was it was a little too thick. It didn't fit on the bottom or the top. I was hoping that it would because I didn't want to cover those dash lines. So what I ended up having to do was cut each of the pieces in half. It was definitely not the easiest thing. This is the first time I'm making a shaker card, and it's the first time I'm using this score tape, so I kind of was battling it a little, but you'll see in a little bit that I will show you how I cut it. And I probably used the wrong scissors for it because it was really, really sticky and not easy to do. Okay, there you go. It's showing me cutting it in half, and the stick, it was just so super sticky and such a mess. It was complicated, but I have to say in the end it was really worth it because these cards came out super cute and I'm really happy. So I just continue to put the score tape all on the inside of the frame. And the reason why I'm doing this is because you want a really nice strong adhesive for the acetate window to stick to. And this stuff is definitely really, really strong. I wouldn't want to use a liquid adhesive because it would be really messy to get that acetate to stick. Okay, now I'm going to use my Tim Holtz craft pick, and I'm going to go around and just peel up all the covering on the red line tape. Also, probably not the easiest thing to do. It kind of fought me a little bit, but I eventually got it all peeled up. And now I kind of know what to expect the next time I use this and do another shaker card. So I'm going to just continue to go around the whole frame and pick up the covering on the sticky tape. And there you go. I place my acetate piece right over, and it stuck really, really nice. And I did have to cut that down because the acetate piece I had originally cut 3x3, and it was way too large. I think I ended up going to 2.5x2.5. I'm not 100% sure on that, but it fit perfectly after I cut it down. And here I'm just repeating the process for the purple card. And I'm just splitting that score line tape in half because I did not want to cover the dashes. If I covered the dashes, it would have been sticky on the other side, which would have been the front of the shaker card, and you really didn't want to do that. The recipient would feel that stickiness when they held the card. Okay, so there I go again with my craft pick, just pulling up all of that covering on the red line tape to expose the adhesive. And just to continue doing that all the way around. And then I place the acetate on top of that card. And then I also continue to do the black one. And there's just the final result of putting the acetate on each one of the shaker window frames. And I'm really happy the way they came out. Okay, the next thing I had to do is I also had to cut down the white pieces that I had cut. Those were also 3x3, and I think I ended up going to 2x2 on those instead. I wasn't actually precise about it. I just kind of eyeballed it of what I thought would fit behind the card. Now I'm going on to my stamp set. The first one is I'm going to pick that really cute little bat that's from Monster Mash from Lawn Fawn, and I'm just going to line it up on the window to make sure that it fits. I want to make sure that it doesn't get covered behind the window of the shaker card. And I'm going to grab my small stamping block, and I'm going to pick up the stamp and ink it up with my favorite things, black licorice hybrid ink. And the reason why I'm using this ink is because I'm going to be coloring the images with my Copic markers, and this stuff is really great for coloring with Copics. I usually use a Momento Tuxedo black ink, but I'm not really a great fan of it. I've been really liking this hybrid ink instead. Now, I'm a little off screen here while I'm stamping, and I'm sorry guys, this is the first time I've done a process video like this, but I will straighten it out right here so that you can see the stamped image a lot better. And I'm just going to put it behind the shaker window to make sure that it lines up, and I just eyeballed the whole thing and it came out perfect, and I can't believe how perfect it came out on the first try. Now, for the sentiment, I wanted to use this one here from Which Way Is the Candy from My Favorite Things. The only problem is it was way too long. It says I'm bats about you or batty about you, and it worked perfect with the bat image, so I did end up cutting it. Yes, I cut my stamp. That's the first time I've ever cut a stamp, and I've seen a lot of people do it, and I used to be hesitant about it, and now I have no problems doing it because it was just such a smart idea. I was able to line up the sentiment exactly the way I wanted on my stamping block, and I'm going to ink it up with the My Favorite Things black licorice hybrid ink again, and I'm going to stamp it under this cute little bat, and it says I'm bats about you, and I just thought it was really cute. These cards are going to be for my husband. I'm going to leave them for him in the morning this week for Halloween, and I think he's going to really think they're adorable. So wanted to do something a little different, and I thought that sentiment was perfect. It says I'm bats about you. Okay, so I stamped out all my images from all the different sets, and now I'm just kind of lining them up because originally I was going to match the frame with the base of the the card. And then I thought maybe it'd be better if I kind of switched it up and I mixed and matched the colors. So right now I'm just trying to decide how I'm going to do that. I did decide, so here I'm going to start coloring my images in with my Copics. So this portion of the video I did speed up, and I'm going to play some music while I'm coloring. Okay, I'm on to my next image. I'm using YR04, YR07, and YR09. I'm going to speed this up as well and play some music again. Okay, I'm on my last image. I'm using V04, V06, and V09. And again, I'm going to speed this up and we're going to listen to music again. Okay, after I finish coloring my images, I'm just deciding on which colors I'm going to match with which frames, with which card bases. Now I'm going to take out my foam tape. Now my foam tape is really, really wide, so I'm going to end up having to cut it down. I'm going to line the whole outer portion of the shaker frame with the foam tape, and I'm going to cut it actually in thirds, not just in half, because that's how wide of a foam tape I had. And I'm going to go all around the card, and I'm going to speed this up a little bit because it does take some time. And what I'm going to do is two layers. And the reason why I'm doing two layers is because I just feel that the sequence that you put inside the shaker card move around a lot better if there's two layers. If you only put one layer, I feel like the sequence get trapped. So I'm just peeling off the first layer, and then I'm going to go around and I'm going to put on a second layer right on top of the other. And when that's done, I'm going to add my sequins inside the card. And I wasn't really sure how many to put in, and I don't have the best sequence. These are just some random ones I had laying around from my Scraptastic kits. Some of them were a little too large, but I think they worked out in the end. And then here I just eyeballed it. I put the stamped image onto the frame, and that is it. My little shaker card is all done, the shaker portion of it. And I was really, really, really happy the way that came out. So now I'm just going to attach it onto the card base, and I'm just using my Plus Tape Runner, which I absolutely love. I cannot work without the Plus Tape. I've gotten so addicted to it. So I'm just going to press that down onto the card base, and there is my shaker card complete. I'm really, really happy about it. Now, I didn't put anything in the inside yet because I'm not really sure what I'm going to do as far as writing in the inside of the card. And now we're going on to the next card, which is the pumpkin. It also came out really super cute, and I'm glad that I mixed the frames with the base card colors and didn't make them the same, because I like that they're mixed up. And this was the bat, and all the little sequins are shaking around. So that's it, guys. Those are the three cards that I created. I'm really happy with the results. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.